Well, this will probably end up being slightly scuffed because I don't know how to do voiceovers and it's my first time drawing. But I wanted to share my process on the skins for this month's fashionable trainers. So this had to take two different attempts because the first one didn't work out like at all. It'll be visible later on, but it ended up looking kind of like the uniform for American football, which is quite far from like how I wanted it to look. I wanted it to be sort of resembling of what people wear for hiking, running, jogging, that stuff. It ended up being too bulky, which just didn't look too great. Overall, I wanted it to have a sort of summery feel to it, because this month's theme was like never and that stuff, but unfortunately they didn't end up working as intended, so that had to be scrapped basically completely and reworked pretty much from the very start. But in the first version I ended up drawing the little phantom wings on the back, which I liked a whole lot, and that got reworked into the second attempt. All the colors ended up being just taken from the phantoms as the model in-game. The first attempt was fully shaded. Well, for most of the players, I didn't really shade anything for BSM due to their, I'm not fully sure what pronounce they use, unfortunately. Due to their skin not really having that much of shading, I preferred to leave the coat. I'm not sure what that first attempt really was. I guess a shirt. Just flat, so that it would just go a bit better with their skin. Because otherwise I felt that it would just clash too much with just everything. For him originally, I thought of like also changing the little brim thing on the hat, but I never ended up actually doing that. I probably should've and like made it blue, because I think that would've made it look a bit nicer and just more unified, but I just sort of forgot about it at one point, but it was a bit too late, so that was slightly upsetting. The second attempt was mostly inspired by the idea of the wings on the back themselves. I didn't really know what to do otherwise. It ended up being a leather jacket with a sort of a print or an embroidery, not sure, on the back that I just thought would look cool. Honestly, it was the first thought I had, and the second I just really thought of it, I just messaged Thomas being like, oh hey, how do you like that option? And I sent him the little sketch I did originally. The leather jackets themselves ended up being really nice, and honestly, that's only the third time I've made skins for Clash that I would have actually liked to buy. So I think if it's something I would have liked to wear in real life, and I think it's just a job well done, if it ended up being that nice in my own opinion. So it wasn't really too tough to like figure out, I guess. But overall, it was really painful. It took me a really long while to go through a ton of options. I have like 3 pages just sketched in pen of how I was thinking of doing it, but I just didn't actually do it that way. It would have been too complicated, and it would have required basically changing the whole skin for the person, so it would have just left basically just the face of the whatever player would have used it. But I thought that it would be a bit bad and it would make all the players unrecognizable, so I obviously decided to drop that idea. This was enjoyable to listen to. Thanks for watching.